Hi and welcome to Excel Vehicle Management System. This is my storage area for the form. So if I want to go back, I can always click on back to form. There we go. And now, supposing we have a customer who wants to purchase a car from us, we can always enter the name of this customer there. Let's say the customer name is Steve Michael, right? And the surname is, let's say, is Adi Jones. Address number 18. Let's say Echo Road. Okay, maybe Lagos. Then postcode. Let's say JJ88. Telephone number. Email address. SteveM@hotmail. And then we can then select the type of car Steve would like to buy. Maybe he wants Bugatti, and does he intend to trade in his old car, his old Bugatti? Yes. Now he wants the following accessories in his new car. Now let's find out the total. That's what it's going to cost him. It's going to cost him 292,000 plus. Okay, so we can then enter our receipt there. Alright, let's enter his details there. Then, if you want to see his details stored on the spreadsheet, just click on open. And there we go. That is Steve. That's Steve's details there. Okay, cool. Events. Back there. Supposing we have my good friend in Canada, my Canadian friend, Phyllis Canada. Let's see. Oh, let's give his surname as Canada. An address. I don't know any road there, so let's just say Kingsley Way. Alright, so postcode, telephone number, and email address phyllis@canada.com. Right. What kind of car does he want? Rolls Royce? Does he have any? Does he want to trade in a car? No. And I reckon he wants all of these, and just select and click on total. Okay. So what I'll do now is to take you guys straight into Excel development environment, and we'll put one of these together. So let's do that now. Hi and welcome to Excel. In this very project, I'm going to be developing vehicle sales trading management system. So let's start by clicking on developer. Once you click on the developer, we'll come to Visual Basic. But suppose you don't, if you don't have the menu itself, you can always come in here and select options, and in there go to customize ribbon. Right in the customize ribbon, make sure developer is checked and you click on OK. Then you can always come here and just select Visual Basic. Okay, the next thing is, let's come in here, select insert user form, that's my user form right there. The next thing is I'm going to define the size of my user form. Let me go for about the width. I'm going to go for about 1000 plus 1020 for the width, and the height I might go for maybe, let's go for 700. Now the next thing is select the frame and enter my frame right there, and let me change the back color, the background color of this frame to something a little bit dark. I think that might be too dark. Yeah, that's fine. And let's give it a name. This is going to be my customer, as customer details. And now let's increase the font size of that. Maybe let's make it 16 bold. Customer details. I want to need a couple of these. Click on it, hold down the control, drag it across, and one more to this side. And I need three more. One down. There we go. Now I have all my frameworks. Okay, now let's run it. That is how it looks like. So I will now modify the whole lot. The first thing I want to do is right here, I'm going to need label. I have a label there, and inside of a label I'm going to enter the customer's name. So that would be name. Now I need more of those labels. Okay, here let's enter address, or maybe this should be customer's first name and so on. Let's go for first name, and we're going to need surname here. Yeah, move that here, and this is the address. Then next one here, let's call it postcode. Yeah, that's all right. Then telephone number. And maybe one more for email. One for email. Now that we have all of those, let's position it properly. Then we're going to now need text box. Yeah, grab one text box here and just copy it across. And there we go. So that is the customer details now ready. Now the next thing we need is we now need combo box. Yeah, combo box right here. In the case of the combo box, let's copy two of these across. One here, one there, and one more combo box here. This is going to be, let's call the first one choose a call, and the second one is going to be, let's call the first one choose trading a car, choose a car. Right. Okay, I'm going to also need two more of these. In fact, three more. Yeah, two more each. Yeah, one here. Right. Here, this is going to be known as cost of car. And here, that is car. car mileage. This is car mileage. I think this thing is going to take too long to design, so I may have to speed up the whole design of the interface and get back to you guys. Okay guys, I've finished the design of the interface. Let me show you guys how it looks. You have to bear with me because it will take too long, so I have to design the whole interface. So all of these are just text box. You can see where we can enter data in there, and this is a combo box. Nothing is done to those combo box here. These are labels. Labels here, and this is a checkbox. Then we have buttons here, and here we have a text box. So the next thing I want to do now is maybe take care of the reset button first. So let's come in here, double click on the reset button right there. Those are the lines of code for the reset buttons. Okay, so if I run the program now and enter any data in here and click on reset there, you see. Then the next one is, let's take care of this very one. So double click on exit, and those are the lines of code for exits. As you can see, I declare a variable and I pass on the message to the variable, and that is it right there. So once it's yes, the system becomes exit. Alright. So I have exit and I have resets. Now back onto the form. The next thing we want to do is to initialize. Let's double click on the form itself and select initialize right here. There. So those two combo box, we should actually give them a name. Let's call it CHK. No, it's a combo. C. That will be car. And this one is going to be called travel. Or mileage. CHK mileage. Or CMB mileage. So this one is CMB car. Alright. So when we double click on our form, we'll get back into. Okay, right here in the initialize, I'm going to call CMB car dot add item. And in there, I'm just going to enter select, or let's say Lamborghini instead of selecting for now. I think this is a G. And in here, let's see if it's going to work with dot text that is equals select the car. Right now, I'm going to copy this. Okay, the next one is going to be maybe Bugatti. Bugatti. It's a TI there. And followed by, let's go for Rolls Royce. We have a Rolls Royce. Let's go for a Mercedes-Benz. And something like that. Okay, the next one, let's take care of the next one. That's going to be CMB. I think it's called mileage. Mileage dot wrong name, let's say. Let's check out the name first. Oh, it's WG. No, that's wrong. I'm gonna copy that. Come in here. Yeah? this case is going to be, let's say we go for 100. 100 by 500. By 5,000, really. 100 by 5,000. And let's copy. And the other allow mileage is going to be 5,001 up to 10,000. And 10,001 up to 20,000. Those are my mileage that are allowed. So if I run it, we can select our car, whatever car we want. And there, okay, that's fine. Now let's come in here, exit. Yeah, that's working fine. Back into, yeah, I'm going to copy this, so that's going to be part of my reset function. There, yeah, that's reset. Copy this as well and paste it inside reset. All right, now I have all of these. Don't think they have a name. There's no name on that. So that's going to be LBL tags. LBL subtotal. And LBL total. LBL total. Right. Okay, so I'm just gonna speed up the whole process, give all of these components a name. Okay, they all have a name now. So if I come in here, let's go into reset. I can call the labels by name. I would have liked to actually call this label using this same method, but the problem is it will wipe out all the content on the label. So let's just call it individually. Maybe if you guys would like to know what I'm talking about, if I come in here, let's say I change these to labels. And change this to label itself. If I click on label, all of these will be gone. So let's see if I'm right. Click on that. You see that it's all gone. And we do have an error even. Let's see. Here it is, the error there. Okay, let's try it again. If I click on that, let's see what happened now. Yeah, in the case of label, it's going to be label text dot caption, sorry, caption. Yeah, you see what I mean? So that's why, that's my reason. I'm just going to, I will not use that. Okay. I'll call each individual then. So get rid of this. Alright, get rid of this and just go for LBL tags. There. Dot text. Dot caption, sorry. LBL subtotal. Dot caption. LBL total. LBL first name. No, there's no first name. See what else I have in there. I have all of these. Yeah. LBL modified. LBL GPS. LBL stereo. better go ladder. There'll be a ladder interior. Okay. Customize. And I think that'll be all. I'll be able to customize. Okay. Now, in the case of all these, so I'm gonna have to enter zero in there because there's zero anyway in there. Manage in this, and let's see in here. We don't have to have anything in here. You can always delete all the content there, right? Okay, so all of that is taken care of. All that is left for us to do is the total. Okay, I'm just reconsidering. Maybe we should take care of this first. Okay, let's come in here. Let's run it again. Select this. What happened there? Debug. Oh, that should be there. That's just testing. Okay, this is supposed to be label. Okay, list box. Okay, let's go back into double click on the receipt, get rid of this. That should be list box there. Dot add item, and the item we're going to be adding, let's say the first one might be name, customer's name. That's first name. That's just going to be for the receipt. So plus txt first name dot text. Right. Plus txt use the size of this to maybe about 12, so that we have enough room. So if we run it, we can always get the customer's name. Too fast, yeah. Okay, if we add, we get the customer's details. All right, that's good. We need some space in there though. First name, second name. Underneath here, we're gonna have to add some more data onto it. Okay, now let's come in here. You see here, total. Double click on total. Let's declare as follows: name, item, or cars. Let's say that is double. Right. Okay, that's my car there. So the first part of it is going to be space that as 0, 0. So let's say that's going to be equals LBL car dot caption. And the next one, which is car zero. Okay, one more. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And this is going to be LBL. Okay, now we have all of those in the array, so let's come to LBL car in 7 equals, adding all of these together, so let's add them all together. It's not gonna do anything. The answer might end up be 0, 6. What is 6? Yeah, 6. It's supposed to be cars. Let's go back in there. There is total. Double click on total. That'll be cars. Should be S there. Let's try it a bit. So if I click, oh, there's one more. Come on. Hopefully it's all right now. You see that? Okay, so at least we know it works. But this one will determine everything. Double click on that. So let's come in here and use an if statement and say if that dot text equals, I think Lamborghini. Let's see, where is it? Somewhere here. Yeah, equals this. Then LBL dot caption. Let's go for maybe 900,000. Okay, that's the first one. Okay, let's finish it up. Else if it's this, there, and change the price of this. I don't know the price though. I'm just gonna make up my own price. Yeah, something like that. Let's do one. Right. If it's Rolls Royce, copy, paste Rolls right there. And if it's Benz, paste Benz right there. There. And let's change the price around. That's for the Benz. And for the Rolls, let's go for, yeah, something like that. Okay, that is all done. So that means when I run it and select any of these cars, I should get the price in there or the value of the cars. Okay, then click on that. Now give me that. As you can see, there's a lot of error there, but that's no problem. Let's find a way around those errors. The first thing I like to do now is, you see this very one, we need to repeat exactly the same thing. So let's copy that name. That is CMB Miley. Double click on that, and we're going to use if statement just like we did here. Okay, so let's get back in there. Double click if that dot text equals, and I have to be able to get it right. Equals what? Let me cover it first. Equals this. That's all right. And just copy this. Equals that. Yeah. Then we need the name of. We need the name of this. Okay, LBL mileage. Paste that there. Dot text. No, dot caption. I'm actually working with Visual. I'm working with Excel. So that should be dot caption equals. So let's give it some price. Yeah, that's the discount you get. Okay. And we have an end if there. Okay. And the next one, maybe just copy this and let's go for else if, and let's see, that is it, 5001, and that would give us, maybe we can make that about, let's change it to about 10,000 plus. Okay, now, and finally, there's another condition there, that would be 20,000 plus, 10,000 to 20,000, I mean, alright. Okay, and let's reduce this to about, maybe 7,000, there. So let's run it and see what's gonna happen. So if I select this, that's what I get, and that's what I get. The whole idea is to subtract this from this. Okay, so what I will do now is, let's look at the array for this and the array for that, and we subtract it from there. Okay, let's come in here, double click on total. Yeah, the first one for the car is array 0 and array 1 for the mileage. So I'm going to enter bracket in there and subtract whatever we have inside this array from this, then add it all up. Yeah, so if we come in here now, say we select that and select this. So we click on this. The whole idea is to subtract this from whatever value we have. Okay, so I think it's about right. Alright, but Adam seems to like this. So what I would do is let's declare an option explicit right there. And right underneath there, I'm going to create a public function. I'm going to call it iTags, and let's give it a name. Let's call it iTags by value as amount as double. Yeah. Okay, now I'm gonna copy this right there and enter equals there. So let's copy the tax rate itself. Tax rate, paste that there. Let me give the tax rate a value equals 0.05, and I will then multiply the tax rate by amount there. So this function will work out my tax rate. So let's copy this and use that to work out the tax that we'll be paying. So this is the tax right here. So instead of using this, I'm going to get rid of that. Yeah, paste this here. Enter a bracket and there. So that should work out my tax rate. So if I come in here now, let's run it and select that and maybe that, and let's check that out. So the tax we're paying on the car we're buying is 4,000 plus. So if you add this to this, that gives you that. All right. So that's good. So what we want to do now is, I want to be able to add all of these. So if I click on this, let's say the customer want any of those accessory. If you select it, it should give you something. Okay, let's come in here, double click on this, and what's the name of this? Okay, copy that, double click on this, and right in here, let's use an if statement. If chk modify dot, is it dot selected or in Excel, I think is selected. I can't remember. Let's try that again. Let's enter the correct name in the first place. Dot. Is it checked? There is no checked. Is it enabled? Something like that. Enable equals true, then let's close this. Okay, let's enter that in there. Dot enable equals true. LBL dots set focus. Right. Then we also need to change whatever amount we have in the text. No, the caption. Dot caption equals, let's go for about 3,000 plus. Else, we get all of this, paste it underneath there, and this one becomes false. Why this becomes zero? Get rid of the focus. Yeah. Okay, I'm gonna try this out and see if it's gonna work. If it works, there. It doesn't. Let's see. I think it's this. Alright. Okay, let's comment out the focus first. We'll come back to that later on. Back in there. Where is it? Yeah. Run it again. Okay. Check. When I uncheck, I expect that to be zero. Okay, when I uncheck, this should return back to zero, but it's not doing that. So let's come back in here. In the first place, we don't need this really. Let's get rid of it and let's change this to value. Let's try that out again. Check, uncheck. That is fine, much better. Okay. The one other thing I need to disable all of these. And the form itself. Form initialize. So where is my clear? Let's take it from the clear first. Somewhere here, copy it all here. Yeah, and go into form it initialize here, just like you say, form load equals false, right? When the system starts, now becomes false. Okay, same thing for the others. Okay, now let's run it and see. You see, it's all false. Enable false. Enable false. That's good. So, double click on this. I'm gonna copy. I really don't need that, but let's copy it. Okay, now come back in here and we just double click on this one. That is for the system. In the case of system, oh, that's stereo really, not system. Let's paste that in there and become stereo. Stereo and stereo, and there. If we run that, the same thing. No, that's a mistake there. That should have been stereo. Okay, that's fine now. So try it again. All right, but we need to change the price of the stereo though. Come back in here, stereo does it. Let's take off the 3. Yeah. Okay. Now we need to take care of the other 3. There's 3 more to go. Double click on this. Paste. And that is supposed to be ladder post really. Let's say about 6,000 plus for that, and just change it around. And that will happen. Just copy that and come in here, paste. Okay, let's check out the next one. Let's customize. Paste that in there and just copy, customize, and repeat exactly the same thing for these ones. Customize taken care of. So we can now run it and see. 1, 2, and 3. Customize, we need to change the price though. And finally, the GPS. Let's exit and take care of the GPS. Double click on that. Let's copy all of those. I think this is GPS. Yeah, I think so. GPS here. Right, let's change the price of the GPS. That seems to be too expensive. Maybe, I think it's about 160 something. Yeah, I should do. And the customize. Let's change that. If you want to customize it, let's just go for. Yeah, pay some money. Okay, when you run the program, this is what you get. Supposing you intend to, you need all of these accessories for your car, and there's a car you want, then you've done about between 10,000, 20,000. That's the deduction you'll get if you click on total right there. So that's what you'll be paying for your new car. Okay, that's fine. Now, what about the reset? Let's see if it works for all. Good, the reset is working the way we want. And you can, as you can notice, this one is disabled. Okay, we don't have to. It doesn't have to be disabled though. Let's come to the farm loan. I think it's called mileage or so. Yeah, it doesn't have to be disabled. Get rid of that, run it again. Okay, that's fine. All right, there. Okay, the next thing we want to do now is I want to be able to populate my receipts. 1, 2. I want to be able to populate my spreadsheet itself. Okay, and clear this. So what is the name of this? And let's clear that as well. Reset. Dots clear? Yeah. Is that clear? Oh, something like that. Let's see. Reset. Clear. That's good. Now. Okay, for this open, to open up the spreadsheet, double click on that and we declare the following variables. Okay, and enter the data for all of the data, everything we have in here, there they are, add them onto the spreadsheet. Okay, you can see 0. Offset 0, 0 dot value equals name, surname, address, and so on. Okay, so we're gonna have to try it out and see if it works. Okay, the other thing is these are the lines of code that we add all the data onto the spreadsheet itself. So have a good look at it. The variable declared and the lines of codes, right? Okay, now let's take care of this receipt. This is a list box. I don't know. Okay. Maybe we'll go in here. And we can just have a couple of information there. We have first name, surname, and this one, we change this to address. Become LBL address, and the next thing is postcode, and I think this is postcode something like that. Okay, what else do we need? We're gonna need more. Let's see what else do we have in the system. Have the postcode, so yeah, telephone and email, and have customer email then, and address 14, email, right, select the car, select whatever you want here, click on total receipt, open, and if we come in here, and right there guys, those are the data that I entered earlier. Here they are. Okay, so that's working fine. Alright, maybe we should add another line of code to bring this forward. Let's go back into the program itself. Okay, to open the spreadsheet, maybe I think we should just add a model there, and in here let's call it sub I and sub. So in there let's say application dot visible equals force. Then we call the program itself, which is user form one dot show. There, that is the user form one that I'm calling. So let's copy this, and I'll now come into my open there. Is that right underneath there? And just change it around. Here, application dot show equals true, and application dot show equals false. No, that one should be me dot hide. Yeah, that's it. Okay, we'll run our program, and there. First thing, let's minimize this. I'll close this. Okay, if we click on that, yeah, there we go. You see it opens the spreadsheet. Okay, now let's get rid of everything we have in here. And back in here. Okay, let's run it again. We'll run our program and change this. Let's change the information we have in there. Address, postcode, telephone number, email, alright, let's change this around. Get rid of one or two. Price receipt. Open. Okay, let's minimize, and that's it. All right. So if I open, even before I open, I can always, let's say this is there, and that means this has to go. Let's say we minimize that and click. There we go. You see, it works as we want. And suppose we add a button here to return back. Let's come in here and stop the application, stop it, and go right in the spreadsheet here. Let's add a button. Let's see if we can add a button. Yeah, that's a button here. Just add maybe one here. And go to hide. Click on OK. Let's just call it back to the form. Right. That is it with the macro. If you click on that, it takes you back straight to the form, and you can add your all your information that you want. Let's call that maybe something like that. Yeah, it stands for Jesus, isn't it? Or for God, something like that. Okay, now here we can just enter Joseph as the name of the street. Looks good. Telephone number, email address, and select a car. Select another one here. Yes. Okay, total and receipts. I've not completed the receipt. You guys can complete that if you want. All right, let's click on open. There we go. I'm back. Open and back. Okay guys, what I would like to do now is to add the pound sign and maybe adjust it to the right or to the left. Okay, let's exit that and come right down here, select all of this and align. Let's look for alignment. Right there. Let's take it to the left. Yeah. Okay. Now come inside the total. I'm right here for mount all of this. There. And let's run it and see. Just have a look at the codes again. You guys can always complete this receipt, it's no big deal. All is there. All right. Okay, let's run it down. See. We'll select whatever we want to select there. Select our car, mileage, enter name there. Let me go for Dean. Alright, so what we need to do now is click on total, that's fine. Print out our receipt, that's the receipt there. You guys can add all of the information for the receipt. And let's see now. So click on open, there we go. Alright, and that's Dean's information there. Back, open, and back. Okay, and with that guys, I'm going to call it the end of this tutorial. I suppose you guys enjoy it. Bye for now.